Hi there, Kawa here. So, as I mentioned yesterday on my community post, I discovered a fun interaction that I'm going to share with you guys right now. So, the thing with Rinnegan Sasuke is that he has no sustain of his own, and that's mainly the reason why people pair him with Lightning Mane, so that you have the Anbu special tactics, so that he can heal off of it. And then, obviously, you have the addition of having Root of the Warrior. Or you pair him with, like, an Earth main, so he gets constant shielding. So, I realized something when I went to work on this idea. And it's the fact that this passive here, it generates 20 chakra. He steals 20 chakra from his opponent who hits him, no matter what. The chaos is the 45% chance, but he steals 20 chakra no matter what. And it made me think about it, and then I realized that it would trigger this passive on the Wind Mane. This one right here. The Chakra Coronation. I don't think people really use this passive, at least I never really seen it like that. I use it from time to time, recently for the Zenith Arena, because 12% HP is kind of really handy if you're in the Zenith Arena. So here's the thing. Someone hits Sasuke. As long as Wind Mane is alive, it's one of those buffs that don't go away. Or at least it's not supposed to. It's not supposed to go away even if Madara here puts up the space-time barrier. Because it's one of those type of presence type of buffs where as long as she's alive you have this buff. So the thing is, whenever someone hits Sasuke, if they have 20 chakra just lying around, he will steal it. And if he steals it, he'll trigger this passive, which will heal him for 12% of his life. So at 43,000 HP, he roughly heals for about 5,000 and change. So yeah, I'm just wondering, would this cause the scenario where, you know, when you have Sailor Sakura being hit by the Ten Puppet Chiyo, you know how she does her stupid combo, and Sakura is just healing more than she's actually doing? I'm wondering, is that a possibility where Sasuke can actually just tank with this passive, healing 12% each time he steals chakra from you? So, obviously, in the beginning rounds, he's not going to be able to steal much. Like, maybe round 1, he'll be able to snatch 20 from you. But then, round 2, he's not going to be able to snatch anything, as most people queue mysteries. Round 3, there's a chance he'll steal 20. Round 4, he'll probably steal 40, ideally. So, if the fight goes long, he should be able to sustain himself by just stealing your chakra. And, you know, occasionally chaosing people, which should assist me in a long fight. These other two units here are really just supports. There's a lot of ways that you can flip them around. I'm using Kage Summit Madara mainly because I don't take any buffs myself, and having a buff removal is very handy. He's not needed as he doesn't really fit into the chase that much. He could be substituted for another secondary DPS or some type of CC, because this team lacks a CC chase outside of him. You can substitute him for someone like I don't know, actually I'm trying to think of who it could be. You put, like, I guess Susanoo Itachi, but then that's not on the chase, but you know, you get it, you get at least get a CC out of it, because this team is really lacking CC with the exception of Sasuke getting hit. Kakito is here mainly because we need his low float chase to start it off. He's replaceable with Edo Hashirama if you have him. That will also give you a CC chase. But the thing is, I prefer the Kakito because he has the cleanse that I'm looking for. This team doesn't really have cleanse, which is a slight problem. And also on the down low, if you don't need to use the Kamui dimension, you you'll be able to maintain the Rinnegan buff for Gakido, seeing as Sasuke also obviously has a Rinnegan, so he'll gain this 60% resistance for 3 turns. It's pretty good. That's only obviously if you absolutely don't need to use Kamui. There are situations you'll probably run into where it doesn't make sense to use it, so you just don't. But yeah, this is the fun interaction that I realized. And I want to see how well does it work. I really want to see does this 12% heal actually matter. Because if it does, then this is an easy way to sustain Sasuke in a long fight. Because then all Windmane has to do is just not die. And by having her natural draining passive, she's healing herself off her own natural, off her chakra coronation. Seeing I have her chasing twice, so it's 24% of her life she gets to heal. The issue is that she has to just not get bursted down, seeing as she only has 31k life compared to Sasuke's 43, and Sasuke obviously has way higher defensive stats than she does. And her, yeah, like if you look here, her injury stats not even 10k yet, but my Sasuke is 23k, so he's taking way less damage on crits, and there's your chance of critting him is way lower. But yeah, we'll see. She's a move 3, and with Gakido assisting with shields, maybe she'll be fine, but we'll see. I'm mainly just interested in seeing if the 12% heal actually matters. Okay, let's see. Okay, we're just going to avoid everyone with a sled, because that's obviously one of us spenders. It's relatively easy for us to identify each other now. So, in this type of situation, there's no one to CC, so there's no reason. See, look at that. Sasuke just took a hit from Itachi, stole 20 chakra, and healed back to full. This is a move 1, so I would have expected he actually took some form of damage, but he did not. I think he's on auto. See, he just cast my clone for some reason. Okay, we can see this. We see that Sasuke just was gaining 716. It was a really quick go by, but you can see it right there. 700. He lost no HP on that because he was stealing chakra off this Sasuke, hitting him. And now he's, you know, gotta eat through everybody. So, it looks like that's something we could rely on, as long as we were able to keep our Windmane alive. But that was only one result. So, let's keep going and seeing what results we can get. Alright, let's just watch his life carefully. Oh, yeah, they have no chakra for me to steal, seeing that chakra already was stolen by KSM here. So that's another issue with the team you have to be really careful with. The main reason I really wasn't running Hashirama is that I won't be able to sustain Sasuke's life gain through the chakra, because Hashirama's Wooden Dragon steals all the chakra, and then Sasuke would not be able to get any heals, and he also doesn't heal Sasuke. So there's really was no reason for me to use Edo Hashirama. Ideally, we use Chiriku down the line, because he will give us the CC and the low flow chase we're looking for. Yeah, I don't see a reason that I need to do anything, so we're not going to. Not sure if I mentioned it before, but this team does fit the criteria that I always mention. You want the water main and a secondary DPS at all times. It's very important. You need the secondary DPS. So, Sasuke's at 41. There's gonna be no way I'm gonna have chakra to steal. At least I don't think so. Alright, I guess that this Sakura lives. She's gonna get a throw a slug down and I should get some chakra out of her. Or not, because she decided not to hit Sasuke. Another reason why I like to do this with Wind Main is obviously we get that dance impetus so that we can use Sasuke's mystery multiple times. And also her clone has like this ridiculously high percent chance to do a low flow, which will obviously lead into a chase. It's really, really rare for me to see the clone not cause a chase. Cause a low flow. This is a lightning blitz team, so we're gonna press this nice button here and mitigate every single one of those buffs except for Madara's. Actually, we're gonna be able to see the life gain here because he obviously gained chakra off Madara for casting lightning armor. So that was a 1000 HP heal, 600 heal. So he heals, he's literally healing for more than they're doing. That's why he's not losing HP. So this is actually relatively dangerous for people who do use Madara, Founder, because they're generating so much chakra. And they're just gonna be, and Sasuke is just feeding off their chakra to heal up. So I'm doing roughly 13k crits. That's not bad. Maybe I can find someone slightly stronger to fight, and we can gauge the damage a little bit better. I hope I didn't click on someone who is like super AFK, and I'm gonna have to stay there for another 40 seconds waiting for them. I really hate those people. It's one of those things where I don't understand, like, if you're not going to be here for Sage World, it kind of defeats the purpose to even be part of the event. I understand, you know, you do get something for it, but you're probably going to get your ass killed so fast. Like, you're just AFK, why are you... Yeah, if you don't have the time to put in for Sage World, just don't bother. I'm just going to attack this person here who has a sled. I'm 90% sure. Oh, I guess I can't attack that person with the sled. I don't even know who this is. There's no name, 150k. I don't know who this is.
Kotsukano tsurugi. Yero.
It's just extremely fun to me just to see people randomly get chaosed for attacking me. It just brings joy to me. And it's relatively balanced, seeing it's a 45% chance. You know, you have the lower percent chance of actually scoring it, but it's so detrimental to them if they get caught by it. Alright, let me pop this out and see if I can find someone to attack. This person has 3 kills, so they can't be too weak. 280k, perfect. And there's a Naruto. Excellent. We'll allow that. Then we'll cast this. Out healing. So there's a slight issue here because I can't hit this Naruto, but we're obviously just gonna kill off his Madara first here. Hopefully that dog survives, and then Sasuke just like blitz that line and continues attacking. So he's gonna get Chopper off for doing this. So it didn't look like Sasuke healed anything. Is it because they don't have Chakra? No, that can't be it. They have Chakra. There we go. Was that like just a 200 heal? Or was that a 2k heal? I couldn't see it. It went by really quick. Okay, let me just reset this. We're just gonna queue this ahead of time. So this time we definitely have chakra left over. Sasuke should heal on this. That was a 3k heal. And he went back to full. So yes, he heals over 3k for sure. So my math wasn't wrong in the sense that he heals roughly 6k is what I'm... Oh, 5k. 5k is what he roughly heals about. I think the Windmaid's gonna die here. Still alive? Okay, force that. So So yeah, it seems like the one issue I do run into is Dodgers. They're just annoying. Sasuke's damage is not undodgeable. And, you know, Naruto being a immune dodger, it's quite annoying. Okay, so we force his dodge. So, we're just going to force his dodge and then go for him. We're going to kill off Shisui right now. And now, there's no way this Sasuke, this Naruto's going to heal enough to get through. To get through me next round, because he's going to do his mystery, let's assume another time. He's going to heal roughly up to 22k, let's say. Sasuke's going to force his dodge, and I want to bomb him, and he should die. My mistake, he didn't even get to 22k. So for this team, you might want to consider using Anbu Itachi instead over the Kage Summit Madara, as it works just fine too, and you get an extra standard out of it, and you get the additional cleanses. That was something I was considering, but I wanted to play it safe and use Kage Summit Madara instead. So yeah, this is probably one of the problems with this team right now, at least this current iteration of it. If I was using Anbu Itachi, it would be slightly better in the sense that I would get the second standard off on him, and then the second standard would kill him. Let's just kill him. It's really the immune dodge that's really annoying. It's not the lifesteal. He wasn't healing for much. He was healing 100. 200. I was healing way more with just my passive that I was getting off the wind main. Let's see. Is there anyone else to attack? I guess you. You're just standing around. But yeah, so for the prototype of this team, it really was just made to confirm my theory that he can actually out-heal damage as long as Winmei lives. I could say relatively confidently the theory is confirmed. He can indeed out-heal most damage that comes his way. But there is that one fatal weakness where, you know, dodgers are a problem. Anbu Itachi probably would solve it for me. Or I guess, you know, you use Susanoo Kakashi. That would solve the problem too. But probably Anbu Itachi would be the best one, seeing he gives you an additional standard. Gotta say, it's relatively fun to see that Sasuke's life is not moving when people hit him. She's actually getting decent heals too. That was 700 per hit, and I think it's like a 4 or 5 hit. So, assuming it's a 5 hit, That's what, 3,500 heal? That's not bad for one chase. Oh, who did I just click on? Why should I get that one person over here? Yeah, we'll allow this. No damage. Another thing I really enjoy of Sasuke is he removes everyone's super armor. So these three guys over here, they're not safe. It's a very interesting thing, at least in my opinion, that he just like takes everyone's super armor away. So 217k. So he healed a 1k per hit of her that was doing 400. So that was a net gain of 700 HP per hit. HP, huh? She lived by 2 HP until Kamariki hit her. Where'd that person go? Oh, let me just get that out of the way. We got 2 minutes, so we should pick a good fight. Oh, let's get you. Now we'll just seal just in case. There's really no reason to, but I'm just gonna do it. This scenario, I probably should. Nah, I'm gonna kill this water main first. I think I can kill her. My move 1 versus his move 4. I should be able to do 16k. Alright, let's see where Naruto is going towards. Because this will obviously influence what I have to do. I have no idea where he went. So that kind of sucks. I probably should have put up the shield on my Sasuke before he got to attack, but that was my mistake. Yeah, I should just gave him the Kakito shield. Oh, well. Yeah. Alright, we're just going to lock up the field so we don't run into Hashirama's Mishirito. Alright, so yeah. I know a lot of people like to say Sasuke's damage is really low. He's his damage is not that low. Granted, though, at the same time, he doesn't have any scaling, he doesn't have any lowering abilities, but you also can see I'm not using any buffs. And the person I just fought is 200. Where are you? 278 max. So their current power right now is 272. I obviously still have like, was it 50k? Yeah, like 50k on him. But still, his damage is not that low. Yeah, you clearly saw I blew up that move for Water Maid in one chase, one mystery, because the second time around there was no chase. Let's just look at her stats. So a little under the HP I have on my Wind main, and roughly the same amount of defensive stats. So 56k, I'm 64k. So it's like a few thousand off, nothing big. And as you see, my HP and his defense stats are roughly the same. So yeah, I blew him up no problem. So I don't know, people think Sasuke's damage is bad. I don't know, I think it's relatively decent. I don't have any buffs, as you can see, and I was doing that. So you can imagine how strong he is if I actually had buffs. But yeah, I consider this experiment a very good success. We were able to see that as long as Wind Main does not die, and Sasuke has Chakra to steal, Sasuke will out-heal almost any damage you throw at him. And if you're generating Chakra and he's stealing it, you're in a world of pain, because you saw that Conan, it was a net gain of 700 life every time she hit him. So most of the fights he stayed at almost max HP. The only time where his HP went down was really because Wind Main died, and the fight got prolonged, and you know, she died. But if I was to make changes, I'll probably switch this to Anbu Itachi, and when we get Chiriku, you'll put Chiriku here. And if it's Anbu Itachi, this chase obviously changes. You will probably change this to shoot down Rasengan, and you maintain everything else. And Chiriku will give us a resistance buff, so Sasuke will be even more tanky. But we do give up the cleanse, because you don't have Gakido no more. But it should be fine, because Chiriku is immune, and Itachi is cleanses himself, and you know, yeah, it should be fine. But yeah, my experiment, I consider it a very good success. I'll keep testing out other things, but yeah, if you guys discover some random stuff like this, let me know. Alrighty, and this is the end of the video. Have fun.